Success is the sum of small efforts, repeated day in and day out. In this video, we will create a functional habit tracker in Notion. We will be using buttons and progress bars to make habit tracking more fun and help us better visualize our progress. At the end of this video, you'll have a habit tracker to assist you in cultivating, managing, and tracking your daily habits together. Now let's get right into building the habit tracker in Notion. Let's start by opening two empty pages in Notion. One is for dashboard and one for database. By providing dashboards and databases separately, it allows for better data management and prevents overlap. First, let's navigate to the dashboard page. Turn it to full width and enter the page name and icon. Next, open the database page. As with the dashboard, give it a name and an icon. Use the inline database command to create a habit tracker database. Then hide the database title and delete the default properties. Next, we'll add a checkbox property for each habit we want to track. To keep the dashboard neat and tidy, label each checkbox property with the title of our habit and choose an icon to represent each habit. Next, let's create a progress bar to track our daily completion. We'll need to add a formula property and name it Total Progress, then select an icon to represent it. Next, open the Notion Formula Editing page and input the two-number formula. Inside the two-number brackets, add your habit. Repeat this until you have added all the habits you have to your formula and add plus signs between them. Then, add the parentheses at the beginning and end of the formula. Divide by the number of habits you have and multiply by 1,000. Again, put parentheses at the beginning and end of the formula. At the beginning of the formula, use the round formula. Finally, divide by 1,000 at the end of the formula. Returning to the Habit Tracker database, right-click on this property and choose Edit Property. Change the number format to percent. Select Bar as the display format and choose a color to create a beautiful progress bar. Once done, we can try out this progress bar to ensure it works properly. Finally, add a date to this database to better track our habits over time. After confirming that all functions are working properly, let's add some data to this database. Next, we'll create a repeat task for this page so we don't have to manually add today's habitat card every day. Click the down arrow in the upper right corner of the database and click on the new template button. Set the template page title and select today in the date field. After that, close the page and reopen our database template list. Here, we will see the template page we just created. Click on the three-dot icon next to it and select this template as default. In the Repeat tab, select Repeat Daily and set the time you want to automatically create. Then, Notion will automatically add today's habitat card to the database at a set time every day. Next, let's move to the Dashboard page, which is the page we'll be facing every day. So let's make it as clean and aesthetic as possible. First, use the Two Column command to split the screen into two parts. We'll leave the left part to the other function blocks for now. In the right part, I want to set up our Habit Tracker section. We will use the slash view command to call our habit tracker database. Select calendar view and choose the database we just created. Hide the database title. Next, click on the three dots at the top right of this calendar view to access properties. Select to display all habits and the progress bar. Now we've completed the first view on the dashboard. However, to make the dashboard even tidier, we can create a weekly view. Right-click on the view we just created and select duplicate. Then click on the three dots in the top right corner and go to the Layout tab. Under the Show Calendar As option, select Week. In this case, we'll have two views. Let's give each of these views a title. You can choose the Weekly view if you prefer a tidy dashboard appearance. You can also select the Monthly view if you want a more detailed view of the month's performance. After completing this step, all the basic functions of the Habit Tracker have been completed. However, during your daily habit check-in, you may encounter an issue. Finding today's date in the weekly or monthly view isn't hard, but it's not efficient and can feel pretty clunky. To address this, let's create a new view on the left and call it Current Cycle, which reflects the check-in status for today. Use the Gallery View command to create a new view, which displays all data in card form. Name this view Today and hide the database title. Find the Filter option at the top and filter out all data except for today. This way, only today's check-in cards will remain. Click on the three dots at the top to access the Properties tab and select All Habits and Progress Bars. This allows us to directly check in for today in the Current Cycle section and insight into the completion process. At this point, you'll notice that checking in on our phones often leads to accidental taps. To be even more efficient, we want to make it easy to check in our daily habits, no matter what client we are on. Add a check-in section above the Current Cycle. In this section, we'll use buttons for quick check-ins of today's habits. Use the Button command to add a new button, setting its title to your habit and choosing the corresponding icon. Then click on Add Action and Show Information. This will prompt a confirmation dialog when you click the button, preventing accidental taps. Next, click on Add Another Step, then Edit Pages, and select Habit Tracker as the database. Create a filter for today's check-in so that the system will only check in today's log when clicked. In the Edit Property section, choose your habit and set it to checked. This completes one check-in button for a habit. You can repeat this process for each habit. When you're making the second button, you can just duplicate the first one. This way, all the settings get copied over, and all you need to do is tweak the button's properties. Once you're done, clicking the button will bring up a window for confirmation. After confirming, your habit card for the day will be updated. Next, I would like to add another view from the Habit Tracker database, helping us to better visualize our progress each week and clearly see our weekly improvements. Use the slash view command to call our database and select table as the display format. Name it Weekly Report and adjust the table layout. Click on the three dots in the top right corner to access the Group tab. Under the Group By option, choose the Date property and under Date By, select Week. You can also choose Oldest First or Newest First under the Sort option. Next, click on the number to the right of any group and select Average for total progress. Once completed, you'll have a view like this. I'll name this section Report. Through insight into this data, we can better observe our progress each week. To make our data more visual, let's add a line chart to this dashboard. First, go to datajumbo.co and register for a free account if you haven't already. After registering, connect your Notion account. In the page selection, click on the Habit Tracker page we just created. Then go to the Charts tab and click the Build Your First Chart button. Select Habit Tracker as your database. Choose Total Progress for the Y-axis and Date for the X-axis and select the display as Line Graph. Select Data Sorting Order. You'll see a range of customization options on the right side of the screen. Customize your preferred style. Once done, click the Export button at the top right corner. Click on the copy link and go back to Notion and paste it where you want it. Additionally, while I was creating this video, Notion had already announced the upcoming release of their official chart feature. I got early access to the official beta, which I'm excited to share with you here. To create a line chart, use the slash chart command and select Habit Tracker as your database. For the x-axis, select Date. And for the y-axis, choose Total Progress. Under the Style category, you can customize the display style of your own chart. The process of using Notion's official charts is incredibly straightforward, with one of the biggest advantages being its real-time updates. If you're using charts from third party, you'd need to hit the refresh button to update your chart. I hope you found this video helpful, and you can now effectively use Notion to manage and track your habit. And guess what? You can start right away with the Notion template below. If you want a more advanced habit tracker with quote management and a reward system, check out our previous video. Thank you, and enjoy your habit-building journey.